Robert Troy on behalf of people.
Thank you, Kincorla. Tánaiste, the reports of how and why the Garda removed two children from their families in Talla and Athlone are very disturbing on a number of levels. The fact that the children have been returned to their families has to be welcomed, and we must acknowledge the extreme distress the families went through over the last few days. While the Gardaí acted in good faith under Section 12 of the 1991 Child Care Act, which states, where a Garda has a reasonable grounds for believing that there is an immediate and serious risk to the health and welfare of a child. Following the press coverage of a child in Greece, there was obviously an increased number of anonymous calls to the Garda, which were concentrated on Roma families. Questions need to be answered why actions were taken in particular on this minority group. Let's be totally honest here, Tánaiste. Would these extreme actions be acceptable if the families involved were Irish nationals? Children should only be removed in extreme circumstances, and normally applications are made, private hearings take place. This did not happen in this case, and we need to know why. There were over 9,000 such applications last year alone, but as hearings are held in private, there was little media coverage. Minister Shatter has requested an internal report from the Garda Commissioner so that lessons can be learned, and Minister Fitzgerald is also doing an independent report of these cases. Tánaiste, if there were genuine and legitimate concerns by the Gardaí, serious questions need to be answered. Why were the other children left with the families, and why was it that one of the parents could not have stayed with the children while the DNA tests were being done?
Thank you.
Why is it that the HSC was not asked to make an assessment on the families prior to the removal of the children from their homes?
Thank you.
Ken Corley, well, first of all, I agree with Deputy Troy that the removal of the children from these two families, the reports that we've heard of this, are very disturbing at a number of levels. Secondly, I join with him in welcoming the fact that the children have been returned to the families, and I acknowledge, as he has, the distress that this has caused. No doubt to the children, first of all, but also to the families concerned. And I acknowledge that Deputy Troy accepts that the Gardaí acted in good faith in the matter. I think the first thing here is that nobody should jump to conclusions. I think it's the first lesson that needs to be learned from this. I think that what we need to establish are the facts and indeed the answers to the questions that Deputy Troy has raised. That's why the Minister for Justice has asked the Garda Commissioner to prepare a report on these two cases, and why the Minister for Children has asked the HSE to prepare a report. And both of those reports will go to the Children's Ombudsman, Emily Logan, and I think we should see that played through. Certainly what's in my mind about this is, first of all, when these, I'd like to know the nature of the complaints or information that was given to the Gardaí, which gave rise in the first place to the visit to the family homes, how that was interrogated. And then I think the issue that then arises is the question of the immediate and serious risk to the health and welfare of the children, which is are the circumstances where a child may be removed from a family setting. I'd like to know what was the immediate and serious threat to their health or safety, which was considered to justify their removal from the from their family. I'd like to know how the decision was made, by whom it was made, and I'd like also to know, you know, if there were other ways of dealing with whatever the issue was that confronted the Gardaí at the time, short of the children being removed from their home and from the family setting. I think these are all questions that the investigations and the reports that Minister Shatter and Minister Fitzgerald have asked for will have to address. I don't think any of us should prejudge what the answers to those are going to be, but I do think that we need to get those answers and the information and the reports placed in the hands of the Children's Ombudsman.
Thank you. Deputy Troy, 1 minute. Thank you.
Tánaiste, thank you for your reply. We can't go back to the days of see no evil, hear no evil, and speak no evil. We all have a responsibility, and we do not need to see these cases being used as a deterrent to protecting children. At the same time, we have to prevent over-intrusion in family lives. A right balance has to be achieved. But one lesson that can be learned is that the government needs to publish the legislation which will allow for proper procedures and protocols for dealing with child protection issues. This was promised over 2 years ago. The professionals working in the health service and child protection, as well as the Gardaí, are operating in a legislative vacuum, and we need the Children First guidelines put on a legislative basis to back up in law. As I said, this legislation is overdue. It was promised over 2 years ago, and is an essential part of ensuring that we have a robust child protection issue. So can I ask, can the Tánaiste give a clear time frame as to when that legislation will come before the House? And can I also ask, in relation to the reports that are being carried out, can you confirm why the Garda report is internal and not independent? And can you confirm, when the reports are concluded, will they be given to the families concerned as well as the Ombudsman?
Thank you. Tánaiste.
Well, first of all, the legislation we expect will be published this session. And as you know, Minister Fitzgerald has been bringing forward the guidelines and the legislation. Secondly, I think it's important to recognise that, you know, this isn't, I think, an issue of legislation. This is an issue of practice. And I think that what has to be, I think, addressed here is, you know, what actually happens in practice. We could have all the legislation and all the guidelines in the world. It's already established the circumstances. It's already established the circumstances in which the Gardaí may intervene in a family situation and where children are removed for their own safety. Now, the question that arises is, you know, what happened in this case? And we have to establish what those facts will be. The intention is that those reports be prepared over the next 2 to 3 weeks. They'll be given to the Children's Ombudsman. The Children's Ombudsman will liaise with the families in relation to the reports. I think the dimension which you raised earlier, which is the question of whether any group of people in our country, whether it is people of a particular ethnic background or any other group of people, clearly should not be given extra or special attention in respect of child safety matters. And I would be very concerned if there were any element of that in these cases. But that's something clearly that the reports that will be prepared will have to address.
Thank you.